If you have recently purchased a smart garage door opener, please check if it has the myQ logo. With myQ, you can use a smartphone app to know the status of your garage door and open and close your garage door remotely. But if you have Google speakers in your home and possess a working home assistant, you should definitely watch this video. Without installing cumbersome sensors used in previous makeshift projects, the Google speaker notifies you when the garage door opens and closes.
Garage door is opening. Garage door is now open.
If the garage door remains open for a while, it will also remind you about the open garage door status.
Garage door remains open for a while.
Furthermore, if a smart switch, such as sonoff, is installed inside your wall mount switch, you can make the exterior lights turn on for 5 minutes when the garage door is open during the night times. If you have a wall pad with Home Assistant installed, you can control your garage door from the wall pad screen as well. Also, in the next video, I will open the garage door with a voice command. Hello everyone. This is the makeshift channel that is making videos very hard after overcoming a long hiatus. Last season's videos featured just one big project. A smart transformation of a normal garage door opener. I had no big issues with my became smart garage door opener. But last summer, I happened to install a new originally smart garage door opener in our garage. After installing it, I was able to control the garage door from a smartphone through an interface called myQ. I wanted to use the smart garage door with more functionalities by integrating it into Google Home. However, myQ doesn't seem to work with Google Home yet. So I further searched up, and it is not clear. Some said that we need to use the Google Assistant app instead of Google Home. But we might need to pay some money for the subscription, and the subscription fee is free for now. Also, by using this method, you can only close the garage door, and opening is not possible because of security reasons. Then, another article said that this presumably paid and not able to open method stopped working. So what should I do? Yes, we will find a way. We always have. First, go to the official website of the Home Assistant. Go to Integrations. Enter myQ in the search bar. Yes, luckily, myQ can be integrated into Home Assistant. Lots of things are explained, but I'll just click the Add Integration button here. Hit the open link. Log into Home Assistant again. Hit OK. It asks me to enter myQ username and password. Wait a minute here. In my case, I logged in with my Google ID without creating a separate username and password in the myQ app. First, open the app. Tap the initial on the upper right. Tap Sign Out at the bottom. Select Get Started. Choose Continue with email instead of Amazon, Apple, or Google. Now select your country and go through the process of registering your ID by email. Also, do the process of connecting to your garage door opener again. And I will do one more thing. Currently, my garage door opener is just named Garage Door. This is a two-featureless name, so when it is integrated into Home Assistant with this name, you can hardly tell which one is which, among other similar entity names. So tap the three-dot button in the middle. I will name it myQGD. When you are done with naming, hit Save. Now go back to Home Assistant and enter your email and password you just registered. Then, in my case, it says that two devices were found, and one is a garage door opener named myQGD, which I named just now. And the other is a device called Hub, which monitors the connection status of the garage door opener. There is nothing special here in the area section, just specify the location of this device as the garage. Hit Finish and go to Overview. Go into Edit Mode. Press Add Card. Choose Entities. Type myQ on entity and select myQ GD, the device you just integrated. Title the card as Garage Door Control. Exit the edit mode. Here's a pretty looking card made for controlling your garage door. If you tap this, the garage door will actually go up. I bought an Amazon tablet for $30 on Black Friday 5 years ago, but I no longer use it, so I changed it to a wall mount pad. If you hit the down arrow button here, the garage door will close again after some beeping sound. Now, let's use Node-RED to make Google speaker notifications about the garage door status. For doing this, I will add a dedicated myQ flow tab beside the existing garage control flow tab first. One thing I'd like to remind here is that there could be an unwanted long delay because the state is transmitted through the cloud. So, it could be bad news for those who prefer things done quickly and locally. But for me, I don't have many complaints because the state of the door is notified anyway without troublesome wiring. First of all, I need to look at how this myQ works, so I will bring one event state node here. The entity is myQ GD. Make sure the state is in string type. Check output on connect at the bottom. Name this node GD state changed. Then, bring a debug node and connect to it. After opening the debug window, I opened and closed the garage door myself. Then, I found out that the garage door state changes more simply than I thought. I think these four states you see here are just enough. Now, I can delete the debug node. Bring one switch node. Add four required states, one by one on the switch node. They are opening, open, closing, and closed. Because those are case sensitive, be sure to type in all lower cases. Then connect this to the event state node. Bring a change node. Let's call it opening because it will take care of the first state. And specify a notification message for the garage door opening. Since there are four states in total, copy and paste three more times. Specifies the rest of the states and corresponding notification messages. Now connect the four change nodes to the outputs of the switch node respectively. And copy and paste the Google TTS service node from the previous flow. For reference, the settings of the Google TTS node are as follows. Data was selected as JSON. Be sure to type this string as it is. When you connect the output of each change node to the TTS node, the garage door status notification is complete. If you hit deploy, you can check that the appropriate voice notification is made when you open or close the garage door.
Garage door is opening. Garage door is now open. Garage door is closing. Garage door is now closed.
The delay of the Google speaker notification is quite noticeable. But it works anyway. Sometimes we open our garage door and then forget to close it. In this case, it would be nice to detect the garage door is still open and give a reminder message through the Google speaker.
Garage door remains open for a while.
Let's make it with Node-RED. Bring a stop timer node, which was manually installed in the last video. The time will be set to 20 minutes. Connect the opening and open nodes to the stop timer node. Bring one change node. Set the name to stop and the value to stop. The input of this node shall be connected to the closed node, and its output shall be connected to the stop timer node. When the door is closed, it will stop the function of this stop timer node. Bring another change node. The name is remains open. The message will be garage door remains open for a while. Connect the input of this node to the first output of the stop timer node and connect its output to the TTS node. Bring one function node. It will do nothing other than make a feedback loop with the stop timer node. So it's just a dummy function node. If the garage door remains open, it will provide a reminder message every 20 minutes until it closes. The garage door open status reminder is complete. I'll not provide a demonstration, but when I tested, it worked well. In the video of the last season, I installed sonoff mini switches inside my wall mount switch and make them work with other home automation functions. In this video, I will assume that these switches are already installed in your home and show you how to make your driveway light up when the garage door opens at night. I will turn two switches on when the garage door was open and then turn them off 5 minutes later. But this time, instead of using the existing EWI link add-on, I will use a sonoff switch with Tismota firmware flashed. Flashing the Tismota firmware to sonoff mini switch will not be covered in this video. However, it will be just enough to know that you can turn it on and off by sending an on or off string to this Tismota node. For your reference, I used separate service nodes to turn on and off for the existing EWI link supported nodes. At the end of this video, I will also show you a Node-RED flow made for using these EWI link nodes. First, move the existing nodes downward a bit to secure some space. I will copy the Tismota nodes for the switches I made in the previous flow. As I said, one will be the driveway and the other will be the light in the porch area. The internal configuration of Tismota nodes is like this. First, I will bring two change nodes and make one output on and the other off. And connect the on and off nodes to two Tismota nodes. If you connect the inject nodes to these on and off nodes and deploy, each time you click on these nodes, you can turn on and off these two switches. Now, bring one current state node. Entity ID is sun.sun. If state is below underscore horizon, I'll name it sundown. By connecting this to the opening node, if the sun goes down when the garage door is open, the output will be made from the first terminal. So, I will connect this terminal to on to make the light turn on. Then, bring a delay node. Set the delay time to 5 minutes. If you connect this node between on and off, after the light turns on, the delay node waits for 5 minutes and the output is passed to the off node to turn off the light. Click deploy to complete Node-RED for light on when the garage door opens at night. And, if you use EWI link add-on, prepare 4 service nodes that turn on and off for each switch. After confirming that the sun has gone down, you need to turn on the lights, so connect to the on service nodes. Similarly, bring a delay node and set it to 5 minutes. Connect to the first terminal of the sundown node. And the output of the delay node should be connected to the service nodes that turn off the switches. Yes, click deploy, then you are all set. In this way, if the garage door is opened at night, the lights of your choice will automatically turn on for 5 minutes. That's all for today's video, and in the next up, I will show how to open the garage door with voice commands. Thank you very much, goodbye.